Got him. Oh, that's a nice one.
What is up, everybody? Fish Hawk here. Today we're doing some trout fishing in a small pond. I'm going to show you guys a simple and easy way to catch trout in ponds or lakes. It's pretty breezy today, but that's good when the sun is high and bright like it is right now. It's a beautiful fall day. Let's see if we can catch some. Stay tuned.
I'm going to show you guys what I'm using real quick. 6'6" medium light St. Croix Premier rod. This is a Dawa Fuego LT 2500 reel. And I'm using 6 pound test P-line fluorocarbon. All right, this is what we're working with. Tiny little ice jig. And these are Berkeley Powerbait honeyworms. Just like that. Got a loop knot, so that way it always hangs horizontal. And got a weighted bobber. Got him.
I got more weeds than I got fish.
Tiny little stocked rainbow. Got him. Decent sized one. Get him out of them weeds. Ugh. Not huge, but decent.
I'll let you go right here.
He gone. Got him. It is a trout. Pretty trout too. Came right out.
Look how clear that water is.
Yeah. I'm just casting right out there. I've been getting a lot of bites.
And you just leave it out there.
Yeah, right about there. Beautiful day.
Yeah, it sure is.
There he is. Wow. Got him.
It's a nicer one.
Yeah.
Come on, get out of them weeds.
Wow, you're gonna have some good luck.
Hold still, hold still. Right back into the weeds.
Yeah.
I think it's safe to say that I found some fish. I've caught two out of that little pocket right there. I'm basically just casting around the other side of these weeds. Weed lines are always a great spot to fish no matter what species you're targeting.
Got him.
Tearing them up. All right, another rainbow. There he goes. We're starting to slay him, guys. Once you find the fish, it becomes a lot easier. And they're absolutely crushing this honeyworm. I'm getting bit like every cast. I think I've caught at least 5 or 6 on this same honeyworm. I mean, it's getting destroyed, but I'll just take it off and twist it around and hook it through the other way and just keep using it as long as I can. You guys can see how clear the water is. This setup is a perfect setup for clear water. It's a very finesse approach, very natural looking, and it works pretty good as you guys can tell. I just talked to another guy who's been using power bait all day, hasn't got a single bite. So sometimes this right here works better than power bait. As far as the leader length goes, the amount of line below your bobber down to your bait, it really just depends on how deep the pond or lake that you're fishing, and you just have to adjust accordingly. Trout tend to look up and feed up, so you don't want to put your bait too low, but you want to put it deep enough that the fish can see it. If dead sticking doesn't work, you cast it out there and just let it set. You're not getting any bites. You can give your rod tip a couple twitches, like you're jigging it, and it'll make that bobber bounce and make the lure below the bobber bounce as well, and it'll grab the fish's attention and sometimes entice a bite. Got him. Oh, that's a nice one. Easily the nicest one of the day. There he goes. All right, I think we just caught number 6 or number 7. Probably the nicest one of the day. See if we can break our PB for the day. Got him. Another nice one. Come on. Get out of them weeds. It's not much of a fight once you hook one. Pretty much just gotta drag him in. I think we might have just broke the PB. Another nice rainbow. There he goes. Well guys, I finally lost my honey worm. I think I've caught 7 or 8 trout on that one honey worm. Finally lost it. Looks like I gotta put a new honey worm on. This is the Natural Power honey worm, 55 count. Got a nice stinky smell to him. Thread this bad boy on, just like that. Got him. Just a little guy. Super tiny. There he goes, just a little feller. One of the most important things about this rig is the weighted bobber. This will allow you to cast farther and cover a lot more water. If that's not enough weight, you can always add a split shot. I have a small one right here. Earlier I had 2, that way I could cast a lot farther. And then when it comes to the jig head, you want something very small. This is actually a ice fishing jig head. Very light, but you don't have to have anything heavy. It'll sink down at a nice steady pace, and sometimes the fall rate from something really light like this will trigger a bite. If it's sinking real hard and real fast, it doesn't look very natural. So you want a light jig head, very tiny, small hook, that way they can get in their mouth. And then of course your honey worm, you just want to get it on there as straight as possible. And this loop knot here is very important as well. It allows the jig head to hang horizontally all the time. If you guys want to learn how to tie this loop knot, just look up the Rapala knot on YouTube, and there's plenty of videos that will show you how to tie it. All right guys, I'm going to call it a day. All right guys, that is going to do it for today. Had an awesome day of trout fishing. I believe I caught around 8 total fish, all rainbows, and a few were pretty decent, but most of them were really small. Just a beautiful day to be out here. Had a lot of fun. Hopefully I showed you guys a new technique to catch some fish. All the information for that will be down in the description if you want to check it out. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, thank you so much for watching. Fish Hawk out.